Tell me, are the voice and screen clear? All okay? Are the voice and screen clear? All okay? Yes? Okay, good. So, a very good morning to all of you. Good morning, everyone. Yes, good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. Yes, Aditya, Isha, good morning. Yes, Samadhyaya, good morning. Let everyone join. Start within a minute. Fine. So I told you to make a list of formulae of this chapter, magnetic effect of electric current. It is a formula based chapter. Some derivations are there, but if you master those derivations, even the boards will become very easy. Make a list of formulae, proper list of formulae you should make. Every day you will update the list of formulae, okay? Just as before, for the previous chapter you were doing so. For this chapter as well, you will do the list of formulae updation every day. Just 5-10 minutes every day you will spend on updating list of formulae, number one. Number two, the task of the module. Have you started the exercise 1 and 2 of the module? Tell me. I gave you the homework of this chapter. Make a list of formulae, revise the notes, start solving the exercise 1 and 2. And the third task was to read the notes of oscillations. Read the notes of oscillations and the board's book of oscillations chapter. Okay. If you revise the things simultaneously along with the course, that will be very beneficial for you. Okay. Now everyone be serious. Within a few months you will be facing the exams. All right. So be serious right now. Don't miss any of the lectures. Okay. Seriously complete the given tasks. And also, you can enjoy this phase of life as well. Means, the 12th board exam life phase that you can definitely enjoy. But that enjoyment should be in terms of study. Okay. The pressure of the study, you are ultimately going to enjoy that pressure. Okay. Don't think it as if it is a burden. Don't think if you are doing the task which you do not like. Think as if this is what you like and you are doing what you like. If you think like that, if you make a perception like that, then you wanna enjoy the studies. Just like when I start teaching, I think that this is what I exactly want to do, right? So then I am able to give my 100%. So exactly like that, while studying, you are going to think like, this is exactly what I want to do, right? So that kind of perception you have to build. Chalo. So in the last lecture, we saw the force acting on moving charge in the magnetic field. Force acting on moving charge placed in the magnetic field. The formula was in the vector form, F bar is equal to Q into bracket V bar cross V bar. This force is perpendicular to both velocity as well as magnetic field. The direction of force can be found out by the direction of cross product of velocity and magnetic field. Okay, if the charge is positive, put the positive value, then the direction of force will be same as that of the direction of V bar cross V bar. If the charge is negative, direction of force will be opposite to V bar cross V bar if the charge is negative. If you want to find only numerical value, only magnitude, then f is equal to q as it is. Now you will put only number, no need to put here sign. In the vector form, charge is to be substituted with sign, and in the magnitude notation, no need to substitute charge with the sign, just put the value. What is magnitude of cross product? Magnitude of first vector into magnitude of second vector into sine of angle between them, into sine of angle between them. Theta is angle between velocity vector and the magnetic field. Theta is angle between v bar and v bar. Okay. So these are the things that we have seen. Fine. So write down these two things once again: force acting on moving charge. Or write down like this: magnetic force. Write down once again: magnetic force on moving charge. When the charge moves in the magnetic field, it will experience the force. Magnetic force on moving charge. Write down this once again. Write down this once again. Then write some special cases. If charge is stationary, a revision. If charge is stationary, if the charge is stationary, means its velocity is zero, force will be equal to what? Q V, velocity is zero, B Q V B sine theta. But sir, velocity is zero, everything will become zero, so the force will become zero. So on the stationary charge, the force acting will be zero. On stationary charge, force acting will be zero. Number two, if theta is equal to 0 degree or 180 degree, theta 0 degree means what? Magnetic field direction and velocity direction both are same. If the charge is moving in the direction of magnetic field or in the direction of applied magnetic field or in the opposite direction of applied magnetic field, motion of charge means velocity, direction of velocity. Here angle between velocity and magnetic field is zero. Here angle between velocity and magnetic field is 180. Okay, in both the cases, if you check what is sine zero, sine zero is zero. If you check what is sine 180, sine 180 is also zero. Sine zero, zero, sine 180, that is also zero. Therefore, if theta is 0 or 180, the force acting on the moving charge. Now the charge is not stationary. Q, V, B, this sine theta term, sine 0 is also 0, sine 180 is also 0. The sine theta term, Q, V, B, sine theta. But Q, V, B, sine of 0. Or Q V V sine of 180, both of these terms are going to be equal to zero. So if the charge is moving parallel to magnetic field or anti-parallel to magnetic field cha direction madhe or opposite to magnetic field, in both these cases, put theta equal to 0 or 180, you will get sine 0, 0, 0 into anything 0. Sine 180 is 0, 0 into anything 0. Case number 3, if theta is equal to 90 degree, if theta is equal to 90 degree, then sine theta equals sine 90 equals sine 90 is plus 1. Now how to recognize whether the angle is 90 or not? You will observe it like this. Sorry, how to draw angle 90 like this? V bar, or maybe like this. These are the situations. Okay. Here the angle between V bar and V bar is 90. Here the angle between V bar and V bar is 90. In this case, value of force F is equal to Q V B sine theta. So Q V B sine 90 sin 90 is plus 1. So QVB into sin 90 plus 1. So answer will be QVB. That's it. So parallel velocity will not experience any force. Velocities are parallel kiwa anti-parallel asel magnetic field. It will not experience any force. But if the velocity is perpendicular to magnetic field, the force will be QVB. Up to this, reply in the chat box, clear and written, CW. आठवलं का बघा. कॅन यू रिकॉल दिस वी डिड इन द यस्टरडेज लेक्चर. गुड. टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व दिस एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चॅप्टर, एक्सरसाइज 1 अँड 2. नॉट एंटायर द मार्क क्वेश्चन्स. जे क्वेश्चन मी मार्क करून दिले तेवढे क्वेश्चन्स. आय हॅव सेंड यू होमवर्क ऑन द ग्रुप. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट आता बघा बाळांनो, हाऊ टू डिसाइड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स. वी नो दिस फोर्स इज परपेंडिक्युलर टू वेलॉसिटी एज वेल एज परपेंडिक्युलर टू मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड अँड द डायरेक्शन इज व्ही बार क्रॉस बी बार इफ द चार्ज इज पॉझिटिव्ह अँड इफ द चार्ज इज निगेटिव्ह अपोजिट टू व्ही बार क्रॉस बी बार. ओके, अज्युम दॅट चार्ज इज पॉझिटिव्ह, सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स इज व्ही बार क्रॉस बी बार. So here, V bar cross V bar, you are going to use right hand. Sense of rotation should be given by curled fingers. So V bar cross V bar, force going in. V bar cross V bar, thumb is going in, so force is going in. So that force which is going in is perpendicular to velocity as well as perpendicular to magnetic field. Always remember, this force is perpendicular to both velocity and magnetic field. So this force is perpendicular to the plane of the vectors. Listen to me carefully. This force is perpendicular to the plane of the vectors V bar and B bar. V bar and B bar ni je kai plane tayar zale, the plane formed by V bar and B bar, the force vector is perpendicular to that plane. Means F bar is perpendicular to V bar and F bar is perpendicular to B bar also. In this case, V bar cross B bar, V bar cross V bar, sense of rotation should be given by the curled fingers. So V bar cross V bar, thumb is coming out. V bar cross V bar, thumb is coming out. So force will be coming out. Okay. Now yesterday we wrote this point as well. Point number 4. Let us revise that point as well. Write down. Point number 4. As F bar is perpendicular to V bar, magnetic force is perpendicular to velocity, magnitude of velocity is not changed. Force velocity la perpendicular hai, so force cha kahich component asnar nahi in the direction of velocity or opposite to the velocity. Like this, let's say the velocity is like this and let's say the force is like this. Now this force will not have any magnitude, will not have any component in the direction of velocity or opposite to the direction of velocity. F cos 90 hona na de, cos 90 zero asto. So ya F sa cos theta kiwa F sa cos 90 in the direction of velocity or opposite direction of velocity, there is no component. So magnitude of velocity is not changed. Only direction of velocity is changed. Only direction of velocity changed by F bar. So हा जो काय magnetic force आहे, that magnetic force changes the direction of velocity only and not the magnitude. Till now we have did in the till this we did in the last lecture. Okay. इथपर्यंत आपण बघितलं होतं बाबा, इथपर्यंत आठवलं का, लिहून झालं का, चेक कर. And slowly try to discuss the next points. This chapter is very easy if you once understand the basics and then only just remember the certain formulae. After that, this chapter is simply nothing. Okay. Write down the heading: motion of a charged particle in uniform magnetic field. Motion means you are going to decide the path traveled by the particle. Motion of charged particle. Motion of charged particle. Motion of charged particle in uniform, same magnitude and same direction at all the points. Uniform means uniform magnetic field means at all the points you have same magnitude and same direction. Motion of charged particle in uniform magnetic field. Just keep on writing. Bit number one. In that, bit number one. When velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular, when V bar and B bar are perpendicular, V bar and B bar are perpendicular. When V bar and B bar are perpendicular, gammat baka balanu. Let us show the magnetic field, uniform magnetic field. So let us show that the magnetic field is going inside. But it is a uniform magnetic field. Going inside means cross. Going inside means cross. Going inside means cross. Draw the equispace lines. This is actually a line, but it is going in, so you are observing it as a cross. Cross, cross. Such parallel lines you have to draw. Draw the equispace parallel lines. Show the region of magnetic field. Show the region of magnetic field. Slowly, slowly, you will understand it and you're gonna enjoy this. Fine. Now, let me tell you how you wanna enjoy this. Because now you are going to use one rule which is called as Fleming's left hand rule. Which is called as Fleming's left hand rule. Okay. Now, I'm going to teach you that. It is used to decide the direction of force, magnetic force. Okay. It is used to decide the direction of magnetic force. Okay, now you are going to use your left hand. Now let us make sure that this velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. Okay, sir. Sir, the field is going inside. Sir, the field is going inside. And let us take the plane of the board as the plane of the velocity. Okay, so let us project the particle from this point in the horizontal direction. This is the velocity. Now this velocity is in the plane of the board. This velocity is in the plane of the board and magnetic field is going inside. So magnetic field is going inside, velocity is in the plane of the board. So this velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. Now, sir, we want to decide the direction of magnetic force. Let me write here extra point. Sir, we know that direction of the force is given by the rule of cross product, V bar cross B bar. B bar is going inside into the plane. Velocity is rightward. In which direction the force will be? You reply me in the chat box. Try to do this V bar cross B bar. Reply me in the chat box. In which direction the force will be? And then I will tell you the simple trick. Instead of cross product, you can use that simple trick also. Correct, Aditi. Up, down, left, right. In, out. Magnetic field is going inside. Magnetic field is going inside. Velocity is rightward. V cross B. Velocity is rightward, field is going inside. V cross B. Up, down, left, right. In, out. Yes. The answer is upwards. The answer is upwards. And here you are using the rule of cross product. If the charge is positive, direction is V bar cross B bar. If the charge is negative, direction is opposite to V bar cross B bar. Yes, sir. That is obvious. Velocity, the charge negative asel. V bar cross B bar cha reverse. V bar cross B bar cha directions are reverse. And if the charge is positive, then direction of V bar cross B bar is the direction of force. But let me tell you a simple trick. First of all, you have to use your left hand. Everyone do this with me, okay? Everyone do this with me. Okay, you have to stretch the first finger, middle finger and the thumb. Okay, you have to do it like this. You have to point the first finger like this, middle finger like this and thumb like this. First finger, middle finger and the thumb. All these three should be perpendicular to each other. All of these three should be perpendicular to each other and point this towards me. Towards the camera, you can point it like this. Did it? Now, this middle finger will always show the current. You are using left hand, not right. You have to use the left hand. To find out the direction of force, you are going to use left hand. To find out the direction of force, you are going to use left hand. First finger will give you, first finger, this is also called as pointing finger. First finger is also called as pointing finger. Don't do it like this. First finger should be like this. Middle finger should be like this. Don't do it like this. Don't do it like this. It must be like this. It must be like this. Observe this carefully. Everyone getting it? Everyone, are you able to do it like this? I don't want it like this. I want it only like this. This mutually perpendicular to each other. Did we want to find out direction of force? To find out force, you have to use left hand. To find out force, you have to use left hand. Force madhe fi, left madhe pan fi. Asa lakshat thevayche. Force madhe pan fi, spelling madhe. Left madhe pan fi. So for the force, you are going to use left hand. Okay. Thumb will give you direction of force. Thumb will give you direction of force. Middle finger should be the direction of current. Middle finger should be the direction of current. And the first finger should be the direction of magnetic field. First finger should be the direction of magnetic field. And it is compulsory that magnetic field and the motion of charge. Motion of charge means current. If the positive charge is moving rightwards, if the positive charge is moving rightward, current will be rightward. But if the negative charge is moving rightward, current will be leftward. In that case, you will show it like this. Okay, don't modify these fingers, but you can rotate your hand as per your want. Okay, as per the need, you can rotate the hand, but don't modify these fingers. Listen to me again. Let's say the positive charge is going right. Positive charge right la chalay. Mag current rightward dakwa. And negative charge right la chalay tar current left la janar. So left la janara current asa dakwayacha. This middle finger should point leftward. If the negative charge is going rightward, because current chi direction kay aste, positive charge cha flow chi direction. Pan positive right la jatana, positive right la jatana, current rightward. But if the negative charge is going rightward, in that case current will be leftward. Fine. Now by the first finger, let us show that the magnetic field is going in. The magnetic field is going in. Okay, the magnetic field is going in, and we are making sure that velocity and magnetic field. Now velocity means current, you can say, or that is the motion of the charge. Okay, velocity and magnetic field should be perpendicular to each other, only then this rule can be applied. Velocity and magnetic field should be perpendicular to each other, only then this Fleming's left hand rule can be applied. Okay, this is called as Fleming's left hand rule. The charge is moving rightwards. It is a positive charge, so current is rightward. So arrange the middle finger like this. Middle finger should point rightward. First finger is going inside because magnetic field is going inside. First finger ni magnetic field dakwa, middle finger ni current dakwa, thumb will give you upward direction. Reply me in the chat box, yes or no. Is this clear? At a given point, show the velocity and magnetic field. Velocity in the sense current actually. Positive charge is moving rightward, so current is rightward. Magnetic field is going inside, so first finger going inside. Force given by the thumb. First finger magnetic field, middle finger current, and the thumb will automatically give you direction of force upward. फोर्स अपवर्ड आला अथवा फोर्स जर अपवर्ड आला इफ द फोर्स इज अपवर्ड देन टेल मी व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन नेक्स्ट This force is perpendicular to velocity, so magnitude of velocity will not be changed, only direction will be changed, so path will be modified slightly. Now if you draw velocity vector at this point, its direction will be changed. Now again at this point, now you will show the middle finger in the direction of velocity because it is positive charge. So positive charge chi motion manjech direction of current motion of positive charge will give the direction of current first finger will go inside middle finger in the direction of velocity thumb will give you the direction of force the force will be like this tell me yes or no here it was upward here it will be like this tell me yes or no check if you are getting it or not middle finger velocity First finger going in, thumb like this, force. So again the direction of velocity will be changed. So this will happen everywhere. Even if you do it at this point, velocity is like this. Middle finger always give the direction of current. Now observe this carefully. Middle finger is showing the direction of velocity. Middle finger is showing the direction of velocity. Velocity in the sense, basically it is giving the direction of current. The first finger is going inside. Check what is the direction of thumb. The direction of thumb is like this. So you can imagine it like this. Now see how I am moving the left hand. The force is always directed towards the center. So sir, it is acting like a centripetal force. Yes or no? Everyone tell me, can you imagine the circular motion of a charge particle when the velocity of the charge particle is perpendicular to the magnetic field? Baka balanu, everyone, are you able to use Fleming's left hand rule to decide the direction of force? Middle finger ni current dakwa, first finger ni magnetic field dakwa. Thumb will give you direction of force. Everyone, yes, no, fast. Point over. Good. Very good. Velocity and magnetic field perpendicular to each other. Magnetic field is going inside. So these are cross, not dot. Those are cross. Magnetic field is going inside. First finger ni kaya dakwayacha? Magnetic field. Middle finger ni current. Then automatically thumb will give you direction of force. Now this force is perpendicular to velocity. So magnitude of velocity will not change. Only direction will change. So write down. In the point number one, bit number one, case one, when velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, what we are going to write? We are going to write here, F bar acts as centripetal force. The charged particle will stop. The charged particle moves in circle. The charged particle moves in circle. Then we can write the magnetic force is equal to centripetal force, FCP, centripetal. CP means centripetal. Magnetic force is QVB sine theta, which is equal to MV square upon our mass of the charge particle, velocity square upon radius of the charge particle. Radius of this सर्कल, रेडियस ऑफ दिस सर्कल mv स्क्वायर अपॉन r. वी नो हियर थीटा इज 90. वेलोसिटी एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, वेलोसिटी आणि मैग्नेटिक फील्ड यांच्या मधला एंगल 90 आहे. सो क्यू वी बी साइन 90 इज इक्वल टू एम वी स्क्वेअर अपॉन आर. वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड रेडियस. ओके, दिस वी मीन्स ऑल्सो द वेलॉसिटी. सो दिस वी एंड दिस वी स्क्वेअर यू कॅन कॅन्सल. We want to find out radius. So r is equal to v and v square cancel, mv upon qv. I don't like this sequence, I like this sequence. R is equal to mv upon bq. Reply me in the chat box. Up to this clear and written? CW. Radius of the circular path. This is called as radius of circular path. When the charged particle is moving in the magnetic field and if the velocity is perpendicular to magnetic field, it moves in circle. Radius of circular path. Are you getting it? R is equal to mv upon bq. What is pi j? R is equal to mv upon bq. What is the case? Case is velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular. Velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular, sir. Okay. R equal to mv upon bq. R is equal to mv upon bq. Centripetal force formula you already know, mv square upon r, mr omega square, mv omega. Idha parent zala. Next, radius kadli. Now after finding out radius, we will write the formula for time period and frequency. Time period pan kadu. Always you are going to remember this, star mark this, you are going to remember it. You are going to remember it. Now further analysis is very easy. The questions are basically based on this equation. You can modify this equation to do all sorts of questions on this. Write down. R is equal to mv upon bq. Therefore, draw the velocity symbol somewhat differently because it will not be confused with the voltage v. velocity la small v jara separate symbol kada, voltage barobar confuse nahi vela paije. Next, can we write it like this? V is equal to, try to understand, bq on the left hand side, m also on the left hand side into r. Okay, but in UCM, uniform circular motion hai na, magnitude of velocity is not changing, only direction changing. If magnitude is not changing, it is uniform circular motion. UCM, magnitude of velocity not changing. But in UCM, v is equal to r omega aste ka, v is equal to r omega, v is equal to r omega, omega is the angular velocity. So comparing these two equations, call this as equation 1, call this as equation 2, call this as equation 3. Comparing equation 2 and 3, v is equal to r omega, v r, omega is equal to bq upon m. Angular velocity of circular motion is bq upon m. No need to remember this. If you remember this, you can find out this. Just arrange equation for velocity v. v is equal to r omega. This is going to be the constant thing. Charge of a charged particle, mass of a charged particle, and the applied magnetic field. For a given situation, these things are same. Okay, so omega is equal to bq upon m, but omega can be written as 2 pi upon t, time period of circular motion. That's what our aim is. This is our aim. Take reciprocal on this side. Therefore, reciprocal on this side, T upon 2 pi is equal to M upon BQ. Therefore, time period is equal to this 2 pi on the right side, 2 pi M upon BQ. This equation you can derive as per the need. 2 pi M upon BQ, time period of circular motion. Time period. This is formula for time period of circular motion of charge particle in the magnetic field. Apply in the chat box, clear and written. Now the other points will be covered within 2-3 minutes. Check kara time period aala ka baga bada. Everyone. V equal to R omega or no omega kada. First of all, R is equal to MV upon BQ. Then find out V. Then compare V equal to R omega. Find out omega. Replace omega by 2 pi upon T. Very good. So T is equal to 2 pi M upon BQ. T is equal to 2 pi M upon BQ, time period of circular motion in the magnetic field. Good. Time period zala, radius zali, velocity zali, omega zala, frequency. Frequency kada balan, 1 upon time period karun. Frequency. Just kada frequency. 1 upon time period karta, BQ upon 2 pi M. पाठ काय करायचं नाहीये, पाठ फक्त हे करायचं. यू वॉन्ट टू, आय वॉन्ट यू टू रिमेंबर दिस. इवन इफ यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर दिस, इन दॅट केस अदरवाइज यू हॅव टू डू दिस डेरिवेशन. मॅग्नेटिक फोर्स ऍक्ट्स ऍज सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स. सो क्यू व्ही बी साइन थीटा इक्वल्स एम व्ही स्क्वेअर अपॉन आर. दिस इज अ स्पेशल केस वेअर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90. राईट डाऊन फ्रिक्वेन्सी. Frequency of circular motion. I am saying frequency. I am not saying angular frequency. Omega means angular frequency, right here. Omega. Omega cha naav kaay aahe? Angular velocity or angular frequency. Angular frequency. That's a unit kaay aste? Radian per second. आणि या फ्रिक्वेन्सीचं युनिट काय असतं? रोटेशन्स पर सेकंड और आरपीएस और आरपीएम और ओनली 1/सेकंड और 1/सेकंडला हर्ट्स असं पण म्हणतात. दे कॉल इट एज हर्ट्स, एचझेड, हर्ट्स. RPS, rotation per second, RPM, rotation per minute, or RPS, RPM, 1/second, hertz. These are the units of frequency, F. Hertz means 1/second. 1/second means rotation per second, or revolution per second, or vibrations per second, or any activity per second, only per second. Rotation per minute, RPM. Frequency is 1/ time period. Time periods are reciprocal. BQ upon 2 pi M. BQ upon 2 pi M. That's the time reciprocal of time period, which is frequency. Write down this also. Write down this also. Lihun ghya te. टिप काय आहे? यूज फ्लेमिंग्स लेफ्ट हँड रूल. शिकवलाय तुम्हाला फ्लेमिंग्स लेफ्ट हँड रूल टू डिसाइड डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स. फर्स्ट फिंगर कुठली डायरेक्शन दाखवते? फर्स्ट फिंगर, मिडल फिंगर. कुठली कशाची डायरेक्शन दाखवते? आणि थंब कशाची डायरेक्शन दाखवतो? first finger gives the direction of, first finger will point the direction of magnetic field. First finger la magnetic field madhe theva, magnetic field chi direction dakva. Show the direction of magnetic field using first finger. Magnetic field, write down this also. Middle finger, direction of current. Charge positive asel tar current will be in the direction of velocity. Charge negative asel current will be opposite to velocity. Velocity cha magnitude tar kay change honar nahi hai, fakt direction change honar hai. That also you know. Middle finger, direction of current. Charge positive asel tar direction of current is direction of velocity. If the charge is negative, direction of current is opposite to direction of velocity. Then thumb will give direction of magnetic force or simply force. Okay, this is what you are going to use. Okay, fine. Now let us make a chart of charge and mass. Charge upon mass. Okay, slowly try to do this. Particle se naam, charge on the particle, mass of the particle and charge upon mass, charge q, mass m, charge upon mass ratio, that is called as q by m ratio of a particle. Q by m ratio, it is also called as e by m ratio. E by m ratio also means charge upon mass ratio. Particle pehla particle hai electron, value of charge is minus e, minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 it is. Minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Write down, value of charge on electron is minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Mass of electron, ME. Shall I use some more space for the mass? Particle, name of particle, charge on particle, mass of particle, charge upon mass of particle, charge q, mass m. Charge upon mass means q by m or e by m. Particle is electron, first particle electron, charge minus e. Value is minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Mass, ME, mass of electron is shown by ME, or sometimes people write only as M. I want you to remember the value, 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31. See how small it is. It's too small. Charge upon mass, 1.6 upon 9.1. Charge upon mass ratio of electron, that will be called as E by M of electron. That is a fixed value. Charge fixed hai, mass fixed hai, fixed value asel. The answer is 1.6. to me, you also make a bigger chart. Okay, If the first chart is smaller, rub that chart, draw a new one. Okay, I don't want any compromise in this, because this chart is very, 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 very important for you. 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19, mass is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31. Answer, if you calculate, will be equal to, you can have the calculator and tell me the answer. Answer is 17.6. Into 10 raised to plus 10. Forget about plus. 10 raised to 10. It is 17.6. It is E by M. That's the charge upon mass ratio of electron. These many coulomb upon kg. Charge upon mass. Coulomb upon kg. Remember it. Okay? Remember it. Next. Proton. Charge is plus E, which is equal to plus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Mass of proton is shown by the symbol MP. And sometimes people write it as M. Kadhi MP manta. Otherwise, they call it simply M. It is 1.6 into 10 raised to, here it is minus 21. Which is very, 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 very minus 31, which is very, very small, a slightly more mass, but compared with electron, this is huge mass, minus 27 kg. Minus 27 is more than minus 31. Okay. Mass of proton is 1836 times the mass of electron. Mass of proton, you can approximately take it to be equal to 1840 times mass of electron. Electron cha mass cha 1840 times or 1836 times. Approximately 1840. For calculation purpose, you will take this. Mass of proton is these many times mass of electron. You can do this division and you can figure out. Charge upon mass ratio of proton. Charge upon mass ratio of proton, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb divided by 1 point. Am I right? I have written here 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 27. Am I right? Of course, some exact value is there. Further values are there. Check kara. Chemistry mein aalega tumhala. Have you done this in chemistry? Tell me. Charge, mass, and charge upon mass. Have you done this in chemistry? Mass of proton, electron, neutron. Charge of proton, electron, neutron. Have you done this in chemistry? Tell me yes, no. Tell me. Have you done this in chemistry? Charge of proton, electron, neutron, mass of proton, electron, neutron, and charge upon mass. Tell me yes, no. No one is replying. Why? Kele nahi kele. Bola. Tell me yes, no. No tari mana. नुसतं बसू नका. नुसतं बसला याचा अर्थ लेक्चरला लक्षच नाहीये. चार्ज अँड मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रोटॉन्स, डू यू नो देअर मासेस, देअर चार्जेस? क्यू बाय एम. प्रोटॉन इंटू 10 रेस टू मायनस 27 केजी. Approximate answer is going to be 1 into 10 raised to 27 in the numerator plus 27. So that will be equal to what? 20 plus 27 minus 19. Plus 27 minus 19 plus 8. नेक्स्ट थर्ड पार्टिकल न्यूट्रॉन. न्यूट्रॉन चार्ज जीरो, मास ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली इक्वल टू मास ऑफ प्रोटॉन, बट मास ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन इज एक्चुअली इन रियलिटी इज स्लाइटली मोर देन द मास ऑफ प्रोटॉन. Mass of neutron slightly more than mass of proton. Okay, charge upon mass ratio, charge on the neutron is zero, mass of neutron is mn, which is approximately mass of proton, which is equal to zero. Charge upon mass ratio zero. Neutron is an uncharged particle. Neutron is uncharged particle, so it will not experience any force in the magnetic field. F is equal to qvb sin theta. Q is zero, so qvb sin theta is zero, so it will not experience any force. Uncharged particles will not experience any force in magnetic field. They go undeviated. They go as it is. They go as they are. Okay. Reply me in the chat box. Aapko this clear and written? CW. This you are going to remember. This you are going to remember. Remember, remember this entire chart. Mass of proton, mass of neutron, mass of electron, charge of proton, charge of electron, charge of neutron. Charges and masses and charge upon mass ratio. This you are going to remember. Good. Good. Few other particles, let's write for them. Particle number 4. Proton means hydrogen nucleus. Sometimes they say hydrogen nucleus. It is proton. Proton means hydrogen nucleus, that we know. Sometimes they say alpha particle. Sometimes they say alpha particle. Write down alpha particle, alpha dash particle, alpha particle. Alpha particle is not something different. It is helium nucleus. It is helium nucleus. It is helium nucleus. Now, what is the meaning of helium nucleus? Helium nucleus means two protons, two neutrons. Two protons, two neutrons, electron 9. I am not saying helium atom. I am saying helium nucleus. Helium nucleus means alpha particle. So, helium nucleus means what? Two protons and two neutrons. So what will be total charge? Two protons are charge plus 2e. Two neutrons are charge. Neutron is uncharged. Neutron is neutral. So two protons, yada charge asel tyacha. Mass. Two protons a mass. Two neutrons a mass. So 2 times mp plus 2 times mn. Mass of protons plus mass of neutron. Two protons are, two neutrons are. But mass of neutron is approximately mass of proton, which is equal to 4 times mp. So mass of alpha particle is 4 times mass of proton. Mass of alpha particle is 4 times mass of proton. Charge upon mass ratio. Charge upon mass ratio. Q by m. Charge upon mass ratio of alpha particle. Charge upon mass ratio of alpha particle. Charge is 2 times E. And mass is 4 times mass of proton. Which will be equal to 1 by 2 E upon MP. Charge on electron divided by mass of proton. This value we already know. Up to this CW. Hey, kal laga baga, alpha wala kal laga baga. Is this case of alpha clear to you? This chart will help you to solve the examples. Okay, after this we are going to solve examples, then you will realize that if you know this chart, you can very easily solve the questions just by formula chart, formula chart, formula chart. Evadas karayas alpha particle case. Alpha particle means helium nucleus. If anyone doesn't get, reply in chat box as no, then I can repeat the case. Two protons and two neutrons. Two protons charge 2e. Two protons plus two neutrons. mass, total mass, दोन protons plus दोन neutrons, but mass of neutron is approximately equal to mass of proton. So mass of alpha particle will be 4 times mass of proton. And E by MP value we already know. Next, protium. No, don't write protium. Protium means hydrogen atom. But atom is electrically neutral, so we are not considering any atom. Write deuteron. Deuteron is a charged particle. Deuteron means deuterium ya atom cha nucleus. Deuteron is a nucleus. Jasa alpha particle he ek nucleus hai, kunacha hai? Helium cha. Alpha particle is a nucleus of helium. Just like that, deuteron is deuterium nucleus. Deuterium cha nucleus. Deuterium cha nucleus. Do you know isotopes, isobars? What are the isotopes of hydrogen? Extra point. Isotopes of hydrogen. Hydrogen che isotopes. Pahila hydrogens or protium, you can say. Deuterium. Tritium. Number of protons, number of neutrons, number of electrons. Hydrogen madhe proton 1, neutron 0, electrons 1. Electrons sagalyamadhe ekach aahe, proton sagalyamadhe ekach aahe. Number of protons means atomic number z. Number of proton means atomic number z. Sagalyancha z same aahe. These are isotopes of each other. Their masses are different, but their atomic numbers are same. Number of protons means atomic number. Z same hai tensa. Number of neutrons, 0. Number of neutrons, 1. Number of neutrons, 2. Make this chart. Make this chart. Now the nucleus means only proton-neutron part will be considered as a nucleus. And this electron part is outside the nucleus. Now, deuterium nucleus. Deuterium is a nucleus. Manje ek proton, ek neutron. One proton, one neutron. Deuterium nucleus means one proton, one neutron. One proton, one neutron. Charge kiti yenar baka? Charge will be charge on one proton plus E. Charge on one neutron. Neutron varthi kai charge nahi hai. So plus E. Neutron is neutral. Mass will be what? Mass of one proton plus mass of one neutron. Mass of one proton plus mass of one neutron. So mass of proton plus mass of proton. Because mass of neutron is approximately mass of proton. So 2 times MP. Charge upon mass ratio ka hai na? Deuterons are. Deuteron. Deuteron is a nucleus of deuterium. DEU, DEU, deuterium. Deuterons are charge upon mass. Charge kiti plus E. Mass kiti 2 times MP. E by MP, E by MP you already know. It is again same as alpha particle. Alpha particle yavada sala. Q by M. Charge upon mass ratio yavada sala. Kona sa? Deuterons sa. Reply me in the chat box. Clear and written. CW. Slowly, slowly try to get this. I have remembered this chart, so you can also remember it. Slowly, slowly try to understand. Next, deuterium zala, deuteron zala, ani kutla particle hai bhoge. Number 6, पॉजिट्रॉन, पॉजिट्रॉन इन ब्रैकेट इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज एंटी मैटर और एंटी पार्टिकल, एंटी पार्टिकल, एंटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. पॉजिट्रॉन म्हणजे कोण आहे? एंटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, एंटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बीटा पार्टिकल. अल्फा पार्टिकल म्हणजे कोण आहे? हेलियम न्यूक्लियस. अल्फा पार्टिकल मीन्स हेलियम न्यूक्लियस, बीटा पार्टिकल मीन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन. राइट डाउन एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट. इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बीटा पार्टिकल. अल्फा पार्टिकल मीन्स हेलियम न्यूक्लियस. इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बीटा पार्टिकल. इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बीटा पार्टिकल. पॉजिट्रॉन इट इज एंटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, इट इज एंटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. व्हेनेवर दे से एंटी पार्टिकल, व्हेनेवर दे से एंटी पार्टिकल, कीप द मास सेम रिवर्स द चार्ज. मास सेम ठेवायचं, चार्ज रिवर्स करायचं. ठीक आहे. चार्ज ऑन पॉझिट्रॉन किती येणार? चार्ज रिवर्स करायचा, मास सेम ठेवायचा, इक्वल टू मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. अँड मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन यू ऑलरेडी नो, मास ऑफ पॉझिट्रॉन इज इक्वल टू मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. इट इज अँटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. अँटी पार्टिकल म्हणजे ऑलवेज काय करायचं? इफ दे से अँटी पार्टिकल, कीप द मास सेम, रिवर्स द चार्ज. पॉझिट्रॉन इज अँटी पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, कीप द मास सेम. What is the mass of electron? 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kilogram. 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kilogram. Charge reverse kara. Minus E cha plus E. Electron varthi kiti asto? Electron varthi kiti asto? Minus E. So positron varthi kiti? Plus E. Charge upon mass ratio? Charge upon mass ratio kiti na? Q by M. Charge same as electron in that. Haan, fakta positive cha negative. निगेटिव चा पॉझिटिव्ह. इलेक्ट्रॉनचा चार्ज निगेटिव्ह होता, पॉझिट्रॉनचा चार्ज पॉझिटिव्ह आहे. प्लस 1.6, प्लस 1.6 इंटू 10 रेज टू मायनस 19 डिवाइडेड बाय मास इज 9.1 इंटू 10 रेज टू मायनस 31 कुलोंब अपॉन केजी. चार्ज अपॉन मास, आन्सर इज प्लस 17.6. इलेक्ट्रॉनचा असेल तर तो मग मायनस असेल, मायनस 17.6. नंबरच पाहिजे असेल. इफ यू वॉन्ट ओनली न्यूमरिकल व्हॅल्यू डझंट मॅटर. 17.6 इंटू 10 रेज टू 10 कुलोम पर के जी. आय वॉन्ट यू टू रिमेंबर दिस 17.6. चार्ज अपॉन मास रेशियो फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन अँड पॉझिट्रॉन 17.6 इंटू 10 रेज टू प्लस 10. सेवन्थ, अँटी प्रोटॉन, अँटी प्रोटॉन, अँटी प्रोटॉन, anti proton, anti particle of proton, anti proton is anti particle of, anti particle of proton. Proton cha to anti particle hai. Anti matter asa pan mhantat, anti matter of proton. Matter anti matter pair, proton and anti proton forms the matter anti matter pair. Electron and positron form the matter antimatter pair. Anti particle of proton, keep the mass same. Mass kiti asnar? Mass of proton evadas asnar. Kya mass of proton? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg. Ikada minus 31 hai, ikada minus 27 hai. Here it is minus 31, here it is minus 27. Mass of proton same as mass of antiproton. Antiproton cha mass, एंटी पार्टिकल म्हटलं की कीप द मास सेम, रिवर्स द चार्ज. चार्ज इज मायनस ई. प्रोटॉनवरचा चार्ज प्लस ई, अँटी प्रोटॉनचा चार्ज मायनस ई. चार्ज अपॉन मास रेशो, चार्ज अपॉन मास रेशो ऑफ अँटी प्रोटॉन दॅट विल बी इक्वल टू चार्ज मायनस ई मास, मास ऑफ प्रोटॉन एवढंच. ई बाय एम पी वी ऑलरेडी नो, अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 1 × 10⁸. E by MP काढलं होतं आपण. अप्रॉक्सिमेटली इट इज 1 × 10⁸. यू कॅन चेक द चार्ट. आफ्टर दिस रिप्लाय मी द चॅट बॉक्स. क्लिअर अँड रिटन. These are the particles whose charge, mass and charge upon mass ratio you compulsory shall know. माहित पाहिजे त्यांचा चार्ज काय आहे, मास काय आहे, चार्ज अपॉन मास रेशो काय आहे. यू कॅन लॉजिकली रिमेंबर दिस चार्ट. आय एम नॉट सेइंग दॅट मग अप दिस चार्ट, लॉजिकली रिमेंबर इट. सी डब्ल्यू फास्ट एव्हरीवन. Hello. Good. Next. Let us try to solve the questions. Case one, झाली ना आपली velocity and magnetic field perpendicular. ही वाली case झाली आपली. Motion of charge particle in magnetic field मधली पहिली case झाली आहे. त्याच्यावरती based काही questions आहेत. Second case पण आहे तुझी. We'll see that. But before that, we'll try to solve some questions. चलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन 20. राइट डाउन अलॉन्ग विथ मी एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व अलॉन्ग विथ मी. एक्सट्रैक्ट द डेटा अलॉन्ग विथ मी. क्वेश्चन 20. अ यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विथ अ स्लिट सिस्टम एज शोन इन द फिगर इज टू बी यूज्ड एज अ मोमेंटम फिल्टर फॉर हाई एनर्जी चार्ज पार्टिकल्स. ओके, यू वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट अ मोमेंटम फिल्टर. ओके, म्हणजे ज्यांचा मोमेंटम हाय आहे ती लोक बाजूला, ज्यांचा मोमेंटम कमी आहे ती लोक बाजूला. क्रिएट अ मोमेंटम फिल्टर. क्रिएट अ मोमेंटम फिल्टर. मोमेंटम फिल्टर क्रिएट करायचं, ठीक आहे. और हाय एनर्जी चार्ज पार्टिकल्स विथ अ फील्ड ऑफ बी टेस्ला. मॅग्नेटिक फील्डची व्हॅल्यू किती दिली आहे? मॅग्नेटिक फील्डची व्हॅल्यू दिली आहे बी. Magnetic field equal to B Tesla. With a field of B Tesla, it is found that the filter transmits alpha particles each of energy 5.3 mega electron volt. Kunala transmit kela dena filter. Just keep on writing slowly, you will understand. Filter transmits alpha particles. Now we know what is the meaning of alpha particle. Each of energy alpha particle of energy, what is the energy they are giving? 5.3 mega electron volt. But sir, energy in mega electron volt, mega means 10^6. Mega means 10^6. Electron volt means what? Electron volt, one electron volt, remember, extra point. Electron volt is a unit of energy. One electron volt, charge into potential difference, W is equal to VQ, potential difference into charge. So one electron volt, I am not writing this minus sign, it's a method to write a multiplication of two units. Electron volt, one electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10^-19 joule. It is work done to move a electron across one volt. Electron la across one volt move kardana kiti work done huil. W is equal to VQ mana kiwa V delta Q, Q delta V mana. W is equal to VQ mana, you want delta V into Q mana. If you want to say VQ, that is also okay. V is the potential difference, Q is the charge. So electron la ek volt na move karnyasathi kiti work done hoil. To move an electron by a amount of to move an electron across one volt potential difference, what is the amount of work done? Charge hai 1.6 into 10^-19. Just find the numerical value. Potential difference of one volt, that will be equal to, this is in coulomb, this is in volt, so that will be equal to 1.6 into 10^-19 coulomb volt. Coulomb into volt means joule. Coulomb into volt means joule. 1.6 into 10^-19. these many joules. Okay, but this work done to move a electron across a one volt potential difference, work done to move an electron across a potential difference of one volt is called as one electron volt, one EV. So one electron volt is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. This is also the extra point. Electron volt, call 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. It is work done to the electron across a one volt potential difference. It is called as electron volt. Electron volt is a smaller unit of energy. Mega means 10 raised to 6. Electron volt means 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Electron volt la kasa replace karayacha? But joule la replace karayacha asel tar 1 joule will be replaced by what? This 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 divide karayla. So 1 electron volt, 1 EV divided by this entire value 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So electron volt is a unit of energy. So joule, J la kiwa joule la 1 J or 1 joule replace karayacha asel tar 1 EV upon 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. And 1 electron volt la replace karayacha asel tar 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. Right now I replaced EV. EV la replace kela SI unit madhe anlo. I just replaced this EV and I brought it into SI unit. EV la replace karu. EV kiwa 1 EV la kasa replace kela 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule la replace kela. Fine. So the filter can transmit a electron can transmit a alpha particle of this much energy. Okay, fine. Next, what they are saying next, the magnetic field is increased to 2.3 tesla. So initial magnetic field is B, initially magnetic field, so let us call it as B1, which is equal to B. It is given. Now the magnetic field is increased. The new magnetic field, let us call it as B2, is equal to 2.3 times B. Adhicha field peksha 2.3 times. The new magnetic field is 2.3 times B. And deuterons are passed into the filter. Ata kay kela deuterons. Deuterons are passed into the filter. Ata filter madhe kay kele? Deuterons pathavle. Deuterons are passed into the filter. Deuterons are passed into the filter. Next, what is the energy of each deuteron transmitted by the filter? What is the required energy of deuteron to pass the filter? Filter cross from pude yaycha. Filter kay karto? Tumchi energy jast asel taras tumhala pathavto, otherwise pathvat nahi. Otherwise it is not able to transmit you. So filter is a high energy particle filter. एवढी एनर्जी पाहिजे तर अल्फा पार्टिकल पास होतो. तर किती एनर्जी पाहिजे न्यूट्रॉन पास व्हायसाठी? रिक्वायर्ड एनर्जी टू पास द फिल्टर. स्लोली यू विल अंडरस्टँड. लेट्स ट्राय टू ड्रॉ इट. व्हॉट इज गोइंग टू हॅपन इन द फिल्टर? लेट्स से दिस इज द रीजन ऑफ मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड. Cross, going inside. In this region, let's say the magnetic field is going inside. Equispace kada sagala. In this region, the magnetic field is, let's say, going inside. Now, you pass. See, the magnetic field exists not everywhere. Above this, yacha varti hai. Okay, so what we are going to do is this. We have a positively charged particle, right? We have a positively charged particle. In the book, they have took the magnetic field as coming out. I am taking it as going in. Let it be, no problem. So what I am going to do is this. Here, there will be entry of the charged particle. Here there will be entry of the charge particle, and here there will be exit of the charge particle. In this region it will exit. In this region it will exit. Now, what's the charge particle? We know alpha particle is a positively charged particle. This deuteron is also the positively charged particle. Entry of the charge particle will be here. Entry of the charge particle will be like this. So, it is a positively charged particle and I want to find out the current. So, I will arrange the first finger in the board. First finger board charge chaliye. It is a positively charged particle. So, velocity, direction of velocity and direction of current both are same. Current positive charge upwards chalna hai. So, current upwards chalna hai. So, positive charge direction madhe current dakwa. Magnetic field going inside dakwa first finger ni. So, the thumb will give you direction of force. As the direction of force is perpendicular to velocity, direction of velocity will keep on changing. So try to understand, direction of velocity will keep on changing, keep on changing, keep on changing, keep on changing. Minimum point, at least you should reach this point. Only then you can escape. Only then you can come out. After this, you will come out like this. Because in this region, there is no magnetic field. So direction of velocity will not change. You will cover only semicircle and you will come out. This is also okay. These all semicircles will be able to filter out. But the minimum radius required, will be this. Up to this, reply me in the chat box, clear and written. Yes, no. Is it clear to all of you? हे समजलं का बाळांनो? फिल्टर मधून बाहेर पडायचं तुम्हाला, देन यू शुड बी ऍट लीस्ट कवरिंग दिस मच रेडियस सर्कल. या रेडियस तरी सर्कल करा, त्याच्यापेक्षा मोठी रेडियस चालेल. ऑल अदर सर्कल्स विल नॉट बी एबल टू एस्केप. ऑल अदर सेमी सर्कल्स विल नॉट बी एबल टू एस्केप. सो यू नीड सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी ऍटलीस्ट टू क्रॉस, ऍटलीस्ट टू मेक शुअर दॅट यू डू दिस सर्कल अँड आफ्टर दॅट यू विल कम आउट इन द स्ट्रेट लाईन. स्ट्रेट लाईन ना आत गेलाय तर स्ट्रेट लाईनच बाहेर येतात. In this region, there is no magnetic field. So, in this region, velocity direction will not change. Up to this, reply me in chat box. Is this clear? How to decide direction of current, direction of force? By Fleming's left hand rule. Thumb is always towards the center. You can imagine. Middle finger always in the direction of velocity. Middle finger is always in the direction of velocity. Up to this, reply me in the chat box. Is this clear to all of you? Up to this, reply in the chat box. Is this clear to all of you? Because on the next step, I will write the equation and then answer. Clear? Question clear zala ka? This filter is capable of filtering high energy particles. Janchi janchi energy high hai, tyal lokanna bahir patavto. Fine. So this radius, this dimension is fixed for this filter. Ya filter sathi he dimension tar r tar fix hai. Entry ani exit yacha matlab minimum distance equal to 2r, so half will be the r. Okay, that r is going to be fixed. So can I say now r is equal to mv upon bq. Velocity ani magnetic field perpendicular to each other. Velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, so directly use r is equal to mv upon bq. In the first case, kon hai? Alpha particle hai. Ma alpha cha mass. In the first case, alpha chi velocity. In the first case, magnetic field B. In the first case, alpha particle cha charge. Radius tar both case madhe same. Radius tar, he tar kai physical dimension hai. For this arrangement, radius will be same for both the cases. Ya filter chi radius tar fix asna. ओके, मिनिमम जी काय सर्कल करायचं आहे तुम्हाला, मिनिमम सर्कल दॅट यू हॅव टू डू, दॅट रेडियस इज फिक्स. सो फॉर द टू केसेस रेडियस विल बी फिक्स, बट द मास, वेलॉसिटी, मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड अँड चार्ज, दोज आर डिफरंट. फाईन, कॉल दिस एज इक्वेशन. सर, वी आर नॉट गिवन वेलॉसिटी, वी आर गिवन एनर्जी. दिस एनर्जी इज ऑफकोर्स अ कायनेटिक एनर्जी. This energy is of course the kinetic energy. So write the kinetic energy. Write the kinetic energy as E equal to 1/2 mv square. Okay, calculation pan balanu shika. Now you can do this also. You can multiply the numerator and denominator by mass. वरती खाली मास में मल्टीप्लाई करा. लेट मी टेल यू व्हाई आई एम डूइंग दिस. आई नो दैट सर यू वांट टू रिप्लेस वेलोसिटी ना, सो यू कैन डू वी स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 2e अपॉन m. दैट इज अलाउड आई नो, बट आई एम स्टिल डूइंग सम एडिशनल कैलकुलेशंस व्हिच विल हेल्प यू इन मोर एग्जाम्स, मोर एग्जांपल्स, फ्यू मोर एग्जांपल्स. मास इनटू वेलोसिटी ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर m स्क्वायर v स्क्वायर मींस mv ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर अपॉन m. So you can write this as 1/2 mass into velocity is called as momentum. This 1/2 as it is, or this mass into velocity means momentum p square, momentum p square upon 2m. So kinetic energy, always remember this, kinetic energy direct replacement p square upon 2m. Kinetic energy direct replacement p square upon 2m. Right now, I know we want the replacement of velocity, but you can replace mass into velocity directly. That is also allowed. So that's what I am telling you. Okay, fine. Now let me create some space for writing. Let us write it here. You have drawn the diagram. Understand this one example clearly and properly. Once you understand this perfectly, other examples are just formalities now. Okay, fine. So we want to replace this this velocity or mass into velocity, and we want to bring energy in the equation. So what we can do? P square means m square v square. So just write kinetic energy is equal to p square upon 2m. Therefore, p square is equal to 2em. This 2 here, e as it is, m here, 2em. So p is equal to under root 2em. Some people write, because it is kinetic energy, they write k, 2km. Kinetic energy la kahi loko k manta, kahi loko e lita hai, kahi loko k lita hai. Generally, k and e both should not be used. Either you should use k or e. Ek tar k opera nahi tar e opera. 2em. I use e because I know it is energy. I know which is in which form it is. Of course, it is going to be kinetic energy associated with the velocity. Okay, fine. So this I can write it as momentum mv. So mv can be directly replaced by under root 2em. So that's my equation. This one, this is equation 2. So I will use equation 2 in the equation 1. Let me rub this now. You must have written that. Now equation 2. In equation 1, so radius mv can be replaced by under root 2em divided by bq. That's it. That's it. This is the governing equation in which I have radius. तर दोनी केस मध्ये same राहणार आहे filter ची. पहिल्या केस मधली energy मला माहिती आहे, दुसऱ्या केस मधली energy विचारली आहे. पहिल्या केस मधली magnetic field माहिती आहे, दुसऱ्या केस मधली दिली आहे. पहिल्या केस मध्ये alpha particle आहे, charge माहिती आहे. न्यूट्रॉन आहे दुसऱ्या केस मध्ये, त्याचा पण चार्ज माहित आहे. सो वी आर ऑलमोस्ट ऍट द आन्सर, ऑलमोस्ट ऍट द आन्सर. नाउ पहिल्या केस मध्ये रेडियस आणि दुसऱ्या केस मध्ये रेडियस सेम आहे. इन द फर्स्ट केस यू पुट द अल्फा पार्टिकल और यू पुट द न्यूट्रॉन, अल्टीमेटली फॉर द फिल्टर रेडियस इक्वल टू सेम, रेडियस विल बी सेम इन बोथ द केसेस. इतना तुम्ही अल्फा पार्टिकल फेका किंवा न्यूट्रॉन फेका, the radius of this filter is a physical dimension for this case, so it will be remain same. So r1 equal to r2, so I can write, or you can directly write r1 upon r2 also directly. Ratio wala question kela tari chale. I am writing r1 equal to r2 is equal to under root 2 e1 m1 b1 q1 e1 m1 divided by B1 Q1 is equal to under root 2 E2 M2 B2 Q2. Root 2 la root 2 cancel. Under root. Energy in the first case, I will keep it as it is. I want energy in the second case. मग first case मधली energy मी सगळ्या शेवटी काढणार, आता नाही. पहिल्या केस मध्ये mass in the first case. Who is that? Alpha particle. Alpha particle. Two protons, two neutrons. Two protons, two neutrons. Four times mass of proton. अल्फा पार्टिकल चं मास किती आलं, 4 टाइम्स मास ऑफ प्रोटॉन. आता चार्ट हेल्प करत असेल बघा. नाउ द चार्ट विल हेल्प यू. डिवाइडेड बाय b1 q1 मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इन द फर्स्ट केस, b1 ची व्हॅल्यू b, चार्ज इन द फर्स्ट केस, फर्स्ट केस अल्फा पार्टिकल, अल्फा पार्टिकल चार्ज 2 प्रोटॉन्स 2 न्यूट्रॉन्स, न्यूट्रॉन नो चार्ज, 2 प्रोटॉन्स 2 टाइम्स e. इवन इफ द चार्ज इज निगेटिव्ह डोंट पुट हियर निगेटिव्ह. रेडियस इक्वल टू रेडियस करताना पॉझिटिव्ह निगेटिव्ह काय करत बसायची गरज नाही, नंबर इक्वल टू नंबर करणार. दोन प्रोटॉनवरचा चार्ज 2e इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट. एनर्जी इन द सेकंड केस आय वॉन्ट टू कॅल्क्युलेट. मास इन द सेकंड केस, सेकंड केस इट इज ड्यूट्रॉन. हु इज ड्यूट्रॉन? न्यूक्लियस ऑफ ड्यूटेरियम. हु इज ड्यूटेरियम? वन प्रोटॉन वन न्यूट्रॉन वन इलेक्ट्रॉन, वन प्रोटॉन वन न्यूट्रॉन वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. Forget about electron, you will get nucleus. Forget about electron, you will get nucleus. One proton, one neutron. One proton, one neutron. Mass kiti yenar? One proton, one neutron. Neutron mass, proton mass, both are almost equal. So two times mass of proton. In this way, the chart will help you. Magnetic field in second case, B2. It is 2.3 times B. It is 2.3. times b, bb cancel, bb cancel. Charge in the second case, in the second case deuteron. Who is deuteron? Nucleus of deuterium. Who is deuterium? One proton one neutron one electron, one proton one neutron one electron. Forget about electron, you will get nucleus. One proton one neutron, charge on one proton one neutron, neutron neutral, forget about it. So charge on one proton e, sir ee cancel, ee cancel, sir root of mp, root of mp cancel, root of mp, root of mp cancel. So under root 4e1 baka kiti simple question zala. Now you will say sir this is very easy. Once you understand things become easy. Under root 4 times e1, root 4, root 4 cha square root 2 ala. Root e1 as it is divided by this is upon 2 upon 2 is equal to here root e2 as it is. This is root 2 as it is divided by 2.3. Everything else cancel. Taking squares on both these sides because you want e2 square gya. 2 cancel square gya. E1 equals E2 into 2 upon 2.3 cha square. You want energy in the second case. So implies that E2 is equal to 2.3 square on the right hand side. 2.3 cha square right hand side la. Divide by 2. E1 as it is. This 2.3 square on the left hand side. This 2 on the left hand side. So 2.3 square into E1 upon 2. 2.3 square into E1 upon 2. Now E1 cha unit kay dilay, mega electron volt. Ma E2 cha unit pan mega electron volt in. No problem, just put the value of E1. Pahila case madli energy E1, just put it here and you can get the answer. Reply me in the chat box. Will you do the further calculation? Yes, no? E2 is equal to 2.3 cha square, not a big deal for you, upon 2, again not a big deal. E1 given to you 5.3 mega electron volt, mega electron volt, sir mega electron volt, je unit dile te dile, final answer pan tya unit madhe yil. No problem, tell me yes no everyone. Yes no, bola balan. R equal to mv upon bq wala problem. आणि एम व्ही ला रिप्लेस केलं, मास इंटू वेलोसिटी ला आपण रिप्लेस केलं, मोमेंटम. यस नो एव्हरीवन फास्ट. इज दिस क्वेश्चन क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? अंडरस्टँड दिस वन क्वेश्चन, अदर क्वेश्चन्स आर गोइंग टू बी फॉर्मॅलिटी फॉर यू. देन व्हरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन्स यू विल ऑब्झर्व दॅट almost everywhere you are using r equal to mv upon bq, r equal to mv upon bq, everywhere. एंड काइनेटिक एनर्जी इक्वल टू पी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू एम. दोन इक्वेशन लक्षात ठेवा बघा, आर इक्वल टू एम बी अपॉन बी क्यू अँड कायनेटिक एनर्जी इज पी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू एम, मोमेंटम स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू एम, मल्टीप्लाय डिवाइड बाय द मास. वरती खाली मास ने डिवाइड करा. कसं लिहायचं कायनेटिक एनर्जीला, काय करायचं असतं, वन हाफ एम बी स्क्वेअर लिहायचं पहिल्यांदा, वरती खाली मास ने मल्टीप्लाय करायचं. इट बिकम्स एम स्क्वेअर व्ही स्क्वेअर अपॉन एम. एम स्क्वेअर व्ही स्क्वेअर ला एम व्ही ब्रॅकेट स्क्वेअर म्हणायचं. दिस वन हाफ एम ऍज इट इज, एम स्क्वेअर व्ही स्क्वेअर मीन्स मोमेंटम स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू एम. सो रिमेंबर कायनेटिक एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू पी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू एम. सो एज पर द नीड यू कॅन रिप्लेस द मोमेंटम ऑर यू कॅन रिप्लेस द मास इन टू व्हेलॉसिटी. मोमेंटमला कसं रिप्लेस करतात लोक, राईट डाऊन दिस पी स्क्वेअर इक्वल टू, पी स्क्वेअर इक्वल टू टू ई एम, टू कॅपिटल ई स्मॉल एम अँड पी इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट टू ई एम. मोमेंटमला अंडर रूट टू ई एम, मोमेंटम म्हणजेच एम व्ही. मग तुम्हाला व्हेलॉसिटीची रिप्लेसमेंट पाहिजे असेल, एम अजून डिवाइड करायला पाठवा. यू कॅन मेक दिस एम इन द डिनॉमिनेटर. आर दी थिंग्स टॉट इन टुडेज लेक्चर क्लिअर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन्स ऑन दिस. दिस पार्ट विल बी ओव्हर. याचे क्वेश्चन झाले की हा पार्ट कम्प्लीट ओव्हर होऊन जाईल. एव्हरीवन रिप्लाय मी इन द चॅट बॉक्स. आर दी थिंग्स टॉट इन टुडेज लेक्चर क्लिअर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? एक्सपेक्टिंग रिप्लाय फ्रॉम ईच अँड एव्हरीवन नाउ. स्टार्ट पार्ट करा बाळांनो, या दोन इक्वेशन्स पार्ट करा. क्वेश्चन्स उद्याच्या लेक्चरला इझिली सुटतील तुम्हाला. एव्हरीवन फास्ट रिप्लाय मी इन द चॅट बॉक्स अँड देन यू कॅन लीव फॉर द मॅथ्स लेक्चर. सॉरी बायो लेक्चर, मॅथ्स नाही आज. गुड, व्हेरी गुड. चलो चलो फास्ट. गुड, अँड डू द होमवर्क्स. ओके, रीड द नोट्स ऑफ ऑसिलेशन्स, रीड द बोर्ड बुक ऑफ ऑसिलेशन अँड कम्प्लीट द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ मूविंग चार्ज अँड मॅग्नेटिझम. या चॅप्टरचा एक्सरसाइज 1 आणि 2 मॉड्यूल मधला. 18 ऑगस्ट डेडलाईन. फाईन, चलो बाय. चलो बाय, लेट मी इन द लेक्चर.